Okay, so just a quick one today. I've got to level 30 on my zealot, so I've decided to create a new operative, and as you can see, I'm going for the Ogryn Skullbreaker. There's a number of reasons for this, mostly because I find the idea of veterans a little bit boring. I just really want to try the Ogryn. And yeah, so this guy is not subtle. He charges in, just beats the absolute crap out of you. Like, he's got plus 25% melee stagger. The Laura Protector ability is a really cool one. Having thick skin as well, really nice. I do enjoy the big box of hurt. You can just lob a box of grenades at someone's head and just knock them out. Well, kill them, in fact. Some nice unique weapons. I'm particularly excited about the Grenadier Gauntlets. That's a weapon I particularly want to have, but you don't get them until quite far down the line. But really, what I'm looking at today is just the story aspects. What I really like about the game is the story aspects. You can put together a nice amount of background for your character without even really trying. And it just influences, obviously, all the things they say. So, I mean, obviously, you don't get, oh, you're from the Messalina Gloriana. How exciting. But it's just really fun to just put together a little story for your guys. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm just going to cut this video together with the various choices that I've made for my Ogryn boy. There's going to be lots of uploads featuring him in the future as he gets to be a big, tough, strong boy. Okay, I've decided to go for Rosyria on the basis that small agri world, they're considered backwards by other Mobians. Ogryns are already considered backwards anyway, so let's have him from a world that is already considered backwards to begin with. He's like double backwards. He's so far backwards, he's possibly even forwards. Childhood. Alright, so he worked agri toiler. He was a militia lackey. He was a Grox prodder. He was a Grox prodder. I mean, this sounds like my boy. I don't think he has the wits for anything else. His idea is to just poke animals with sticks or his bare hands or whatever. That's what my boy does. That was how he started out. Okay, so it was a tough call about who to go for here, whether to go for strong arm or to go for local fighter, because a lot of the rest didn't seem to really fit my boy. But I think local fighter, so just imagine this guy is battle hardened, he's been fighting in the pits. You know, he spends all his days poking Groxes, so he likes to go into the pits and let off a little bit of steam and just beat the crap out of someone. Because, you know, why the hell not? Okay, so there's only one option here, really, and that's to go recruited. None of the others fit. He's not a miner. I like to be consistent with my stories, you know? I feel like a lot of guys are as well. A lot of people are with that too. Saved by the Tsar doesn't make sense. Most of these don't make sense for the kind of life I'm building for this guy. So yeah, he's just been recruited. He got tired of the Grox poking, pit fighting life, and he was recruited into the Astra Militarum. But obviously, things didn't go well for him. What I like as well, you've got such a range of choices of how you're going to build your character. This is the default. Obviously, we can do a lot better. We're going to customize him quite nicely. And yeah, there's so many options you can go with, you know? And I really enjoy that. Okay, so here is my boy. He's been through some stuff. He's got some scars. Got a lot of tattoos from his time in the guard. As you can see, like, he can't grow hair on top of his head. Bald, went bald at an early age, sadly. So he makes up for it with his ridiculous mustache. And it's down to personality now. What kind of person is he going to be? The bodyguard, the bully, or the brawler? There's only really one choice here.
If
Like,
you want to win.
be quiet. Okay, so the bully, nah, it's
Not
like
shit.
the brawler, because he spent his life fighting in the pits. And when he wasn't poking the grots, he had to get stuff done. And that's what he
Not
ended up.
sure.
And yeah, so what got him sacked from the guard? I think maybe it was dereliction of duty. He couldn't save his boss. So it's not going to be sedition. It's not going to be misplaced faith. It's not going to be insubordination. I think it's got to be dereliction of duty. Because he tried to save his boss, he couldn't, and that's where he ended up. The name, of course, is the same as it always is. Assuming that I can type. Buzz Killington. You were born on Rosseria. You spent your growing years as a Grox prodder, driving the beasts to slaughter while trying your best not to get gored or trampled. With savage ferocity, you began making a name in a local pit fight with a series of brutal victories. Enlisted into the planet's militia, from there you proved yourself as a worthy recruit for the Astra Militarum. You run afoul of a superior from the Upper Hive and wrongly accused of abandoning your post because the superior's testimony was suspect. The tribunal ordered hard labour over death, and so you were sent to the prison ship, the Tancred Bastion. You were aboard the Tancred Bastion en route to Atoma Prime. So that's my boy. He's tough, he's loyal, and of course, as an ogre, he's not tremendously bright. So have some fun with him. I hope you've enjoyed this little video. It's just fun to build a story for a character, you know? And I hope you guys enjoy doing that for you guys as well. And yeah, look forward to more videos featuring my ogre in finding his way and cracking some skulls. Until next time, thank you for watching.